This is straight from the heart. From the top of the world. Feel the love tonight. Let the music play. Let's go, let's go.
I've got a feeling it's going down tonight. So let's get moving. Turn up the music. Turn on the party lights. Baby, can you take it? Can you take the heat on the floor? I'm going crazy. Can you shake it? Shake it to the beat on the floor.
Dear friends of Tony and Joseph, we are gathered today on this very happy occasion to publicly proclaim the forming of a partnership of two mature equals who, regardless of their self-sufficiency and independence, have come to realize that more often than not, individuals function better as a team. Each believes that the special qualities the other possesses will bring about an ideal partnership. What greater thing is there for two human souls than to feel that they are joined together to strengthen each other in all labor, to minister to each other in all sorrow, to share with each other all gladness, to be one with each other in the silent, unspeakable memories. The marriage relationship requires mutual love and devotion, compromise and sacrifice, appreciation and understanding, and exists for the solemnizing of the union between two people, for the welfare of all families, and for mutual help, love, and comfort of one to the other, both in prosperity and adversity. Marriage is an honorable relationship and is not to be taken unadvisedly, lightly, or wantonly. To this end, we are all here to witness the dedication of each to the other and both to the noblest purposes of life. Marriage is that unique relationship between two people of dependence, yet independence, of togetherness, yet of individuality. Today, you both are pledging to be together so long as you both shall live. But let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of the heavens dance between you. I now must ask each of you if you know of any reason why you may not lawfully be united in marriage. Tony, repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Tony Meddy.
Why I, Tony Meddy.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Joseph Spencer.
To Joseph Spencer.
Joseph. I do solemnly declare.
I solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Joseph Spencer.
Why I, Joseph Spencer.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Tony Meddy.
To Tony Meddy.
Tony and Joseph's good friend, Paul, will now read a poem.
Intoxicated by the moment, enraptured by emotion, captivated by a glance. Look at the two of you. Selves morph into selflessness. Duality becomes singular. Two transform into one. Look at the two of you. Friends share the sentiment. High through mad contagion, feasting till hearts overflow. Look at the two of you. The fleeting times of ecstasy, the timelessness of sorrows, always together, never alone. Look at the two of you. Life unfolds as a mystery, revealed, not foretold, except for the certainty of your love.
Thank you very much, Paul.
Tony and Joseph have chosen to exchange personal vows. Let's start with Tony. Take your time.
Where there was darkness, you brought light. Where there was cold, you brought warmth. Sir. Joseph Richard Vernon Spencer, I, Claire Francis Anthony Betty, pledge before our friends and witnesses that you will be my lawfully wedded partner for life. Over the past 29 unforgettable years, our love has grown into a fire that's impossible to extinguish. Let us continue to make two lives one, and continue to cherish and love one another. I love you.
I, Joseph Richard Vernon Spencer, take you, Claire Francis, as my soulmate for life. I vow to love you and care for you as long as we both shall live. I take you with your faults and strengths, and I give myself to you with my faults and strengths. I will help you when you need help, and I will ask for your help if I need help. I promise I will love you for the rest of my life.
Do you, Tony Medi, take Joseph Spencer to be your lawful wedded spouse, to love and cherish, honor and respect, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, for all the days of your life, till death do you part?
I do.
Do you, Joseph Spencer, take Tony Medi to be your lawful wedded spouse, to love and cherish, honor and respect, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, for all the days of your life, till death do you part?
Do.
The ring is the symbol of the relationship that these two people wish to share with each other. The ring symbolizes the unbroken circle of endless love, togetherness, and friendship. Tony, repeat after me. I do give you this ring.
I do give you this ring.
In token of the relationship.
In token of the relationship.
Which we are today entering.
Which we are today entering.
The relationship of marriage.
The relationship of marriage.
Go ahead.
I'll take this.
Joseph. I do give you this ring.
I do give you this ring.
In token of the relationship.
In token of the relationship.
Which we are today entering.
Within today we are entering.
The relationship of marriage.
The relationship of marriage.
We are grateful for the eternal unfolding of the seasons, which has brought us to this momentous occasion. We rejoice in the blessing of life's passages that bring both joy and sorrow and offer challenge and opportunity. Radiant is the spirit of humankind that illuminates our world through love. Enormous is the potential in human beings to combine love, wisdom, and courage, and to forge a better life for themselves and their loved ones. Precious is the love and support of family and friends and community. Blessed is the happiness of Tony and Joseph, who share in joy and gladness, pleasure and exaltation, love and harmony, peace and friendship. We rejoice with Tony and Joseph. May they find ever-increasing joy as they devote themselves to growing, sharing, nurturing, and supporting one another. May you always communicate openly and honestly with each other. May your relationship remain one of love and trust, continuing to respect the individuality of the other. May the happiness you share today be with you always. For as much as you, Tony Meddy, and Joseph Spencer have consented together in wedlock and have pledged your faith and your trust to each other in the presence of these witnesses, and having confirmed the same by what you have said and by the giving and receiving of rings, now therefore I, Harvey Brownstone, Judge of the Ontario Court of Justice, by virtue of the power vested in me under the Marriage Act, do hereby pronounce you, Tony Meddy, and Joseph Spencer, to be lawfully married spouses and partners for life. Congratulations.
Home. It takes two, baby. It takes two. Shaking it, it won't be. A little, yeah, that's right. A little bit of that first, and then the thumbs to bring it up.
Oh, that's great that it stopped.
Really?
Yeah, the waiter could.
Somebody should.
Now, if you had these amateur products, you had a bear.
You got bear.
Wow, we had a bear last week.
We had a bear last week.
Oh, yeah. Let it go. Let it fly.
We had a bear. It just didn't get an art card. It got into three others.
Really?
They've been having terrible trouble with bears.
Come on. You're strong here.
Really?
A bunch of no waiters.
I'll do it.
Oh, no. It's a huge problem.
Beautiful. Have you got your glasses to be poured into?
Oh, no.
What's our own personalized waiter gets us open?
I can't even open it.
Cindy, can I help? Can I help? Cindy, you want to take this? I'll help with it.
Why don't you let me?
Sure. I just have to, oh, it's on, it's on. My heels are digging in. It's
fine.
Excuse me if it's not straight, Tony.
I might get to light my bugs after all.
Let's try the other bottle.
This is going to be a crapshoot.
Can't drink this.
You can't sip it.
Like a sip.
Please.
Feel loud.
To the happy couple, another 50 years of health and happiness together.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I would like to say thank you to all of our friends that are here, and a lot of our friends aren't here.
And a lot of them are up there.
My mother, and we hope they were looking down upon us. And you could have helped me a little more.
Miss Ying.
My dad.
Miss
Ying. They're all there thinking of us.
Miss
thank
Ying.
You.
Thank
you.
Miss Ying.
All the best.
She's new.
Gonna get married, go into the chapel, and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you, and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel of love. Spring is here, the sky is blue. Whoa, birds all sing as if they knew. Today's the day we'll say I do, and we'll never be lonely anymore, because we're going to the chapel, and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel, and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you, and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel of love. Bells will ring, the sun will shine. Whoa, I'll be his, and he'll be mine. We'll love until the end of time.
Very much, you guys, for everything. Judy and Phil, you're the best. Thank you very much for allowing us to have our wedding in your home, and we really do appreciate it.
Put your hand together. What are you cutting?
The bottom of our heart. He's cutting the cake. Thank you very much. We're cutting it here. We're cutting it now, okay?
Aren't I supposed to pick some up and smash it in his face?
Yes, you're supposed to do that. Do it, and I'll do it.
Not on the carpet, not.
I love the little Nads there. They're so cute.
You're not very happy for my friend.
Thank you.
Who's your friend?